Hey guys, this is a swordfish, as you can see. It has a solenoid in it, as well as brushless motors, and it goes sort of a bit like this. Put on. And it's like fire, all that sort of cool stuff. So I like solenoids, and that's great. They fit into this just fine, but what else can they fit into? Let me disconnect this. I'll put him away. Well, they fit into other blasters too, including Stryfe. So this here is a work in progress, but the actual solenoid component is complete and available for use. And it works largely in the same way. You've got the wires out here, you apply power to it, using some form of control, whether it just be through the micro switch here on the trigger for semi-auto mode, or whether you use some form of select fire auto technique using one of the available boards or an Arduino or something like that. But as you can see, we've got a magazine here that has a single dart, and that dart is going into these it's brushless flywheel cage at the moment, without any flywheels on the motors. And this is a standard 35mm solenoid. And there we go. You can see, that's pushed it way into the middle there. So that is quite a nice sort of action. It goes well. Quite happy with that. So I'll pop him back through there, take him out. So you can see, I'll take this bad boy out too. There's a number of different things going on here. You've got the cage which holds it in place, but you also notice that you've got this component down here too. So this component here provides somewhere for the trigger to slide against. It also provides some mechanical strength in the mounting. So you would put one screw through here and one screw through there, and that will hold it in place really well. You've got the top part here which sort of interfaces against the shell. You've got this part here which interfaces against the shell, and also the bottom structure. But this will keep it from rattling around or anything like that. So you have these two holes here. These allow you to mount one of these super micro switches, and it's smaller than the ones that you would normally use, but it allows you to mount it to, say, here, and then have a dual stage trigger if that's what you are looking for. You don't have to use it, of course, but it's there if you do. Take the trigger out. What you'll also notice is that the mag lock switch is here too. So if you had an Arduino build, you would be able to use that switch there to detect if somebody's pulled the magazine out, to reset an ammo counter or anything like that. Of course, you don't have to have it, but it's an option there available if you wish. And this just comes out nice and easy, sort of pops in nice and easy. This is the 35mm solenoid. Is available fairly cheaply and readily on eBay or Aliexpress or whatever. You also have one that will fit the flywheel of the world solenoid. That's your cup of tea. And it fits in much the same way. There are some considerations when it comes to mounting the two different types of solenoids. Actually, the biggest consideration comes with there's more work to get this one installed, but this one will install cleaner. And the reason being is this is actually a little bit shorter, so it allows you to sort of sit it in a little bit further into the shell, and you don't have to worry about the top shell fouling on that, but you do have to worry about this being quite a bit bigger out here. So take them both out. One, two. I'll take the switch out here. OK. is what we're going to talk about, is what we need to do to cut. So I have here, it's an empty cage. As you can see, it sits down in here just fine. You can see here, it sits below the level of the battery tray. So there's a couple of things going on that need to be cut. First of all, obviously, the battery tray. And you can see the actual shell cutout for both of these is the same. And really what we want to do is ensure that this piece here stays in place, but we need to trim down along that line here as close as possible without damaging this, because this is where the trigger sort of slides against. So it slides up against here, and that holds the trigger in place and it gives it a nice smooth feel. And we want to sort of come, like you see there's a little divot here, right there. And that's sort of, I don't know what that is, but it's just sort of there. And basically from that point, you're going to go straight up. Okay. And then once you get to the top, you can open up a little bit more for the wires to go in. You don't have to do that, but you can. It's a good idea, so you can get some wiring sort of through the battery tray. And then what you want to do is make sure it's nice and open all the way up here for convenience. You don't have to, but it just makes it a lot easier. And then it comes down here, so where you've got this screw hole here, it's sort of roughly in line with the center line of that screw hole. We're going to go straight up and down here, and then we're going to come out and then down at an angle to sort of meet that. Now this screw hole here we will use to retain the solenoid, as well as this screw hole here, and that will allow us to sit the solenoid in place. What's important is we don't cut too far away from here, and we don't cut too much of that away, because this part here and this part here sit in that like this. And it just sort of sits down there. I don't think that's in right. But anyway, it sort of serves, you get the sort of feel for it, right? All the rest around here we're not going to change, and that's sort of nice and sweet. Pop it around the other side, you can see the battery tray has been cleaned out. You've got a cutout in each of these for the wires to go through, and there's a bit of a story behind this too. The actual thickness is about 1 millimeter here, so you don't lose much of that battery tray area out to the solenoid shell, but that just sort of holds it in place, makes it reasonably strong and secure. In both cases, what you will be doing is trimming this out, and you'll need to trim off the rear screw post. And this is one of the differences with the FTW solenoid versus, and there we go, pop it down. You can see the solenoid comes up through this area here, it is offset, and that gives it a good sort of position for the solenoid, where we can use it effectively, but also the ideal pusher position. So what we'll need to do is clear some things out here, and I'll show you this in a sec. Now I haven't needed to cut this off, but be prepared just in case, and don't fret too much if you have to lose it. I don't think that actually serves any purpose. This part here is the bottom landing area. You need to leave this intact. And this part here, you need to leave this intact too. Now, in the uncut version, this will then come up and then around here to support all this structure. But what we're going to do is actually cut that down at about a 45 degree angle, maybe not quite, until it gets down to this level here. And you see this piece here is original and stock, and we want to make sure the rest of this stuff here and this stuff here and that line all the way along here is the same level as this. Do that, it'll fit in just nicely. You see there is a little bit of room if you get it wrong, and so on and so forth, but not too much. I think it'll be a good idea to cut this off. The This stuff around here, we don't need to touch. Up around here, we don't need to worry about this. In fact, this component here will actually fit in there just well. That's all you need. In this particular case here, because it's going to be very difficult to run a whole bunch of wire and stuff up through there, what I have done is I've cut the hole through here to allow access into the battery tray, and then you can sort of 3D print a panel that goes over the top of this, no problems. Other than that, that's all that we need to cut to support that. Pop him aside. On here, obviously there's going to be some cutting too. The rear pusher area, you need to make sure, or the rear screw area, you need to make sure that is smooth, very trim for the FTW, just far enough for the regular solenoid. These three here, if you're using the 35mm solenoid, you don't need to worry about that. If you're using the FTW solenoid, this will need to be trimmed. 1, 2, 3. And then around here, this is where we need to start doing a bit of trimming. So you can see this here is about maybe 15mm from here down. And when we put this in place upside down like that, you can see it just sort of fits in. And that's what we're looking for. We're looking for this to just sort of fit in nicely. It's about 15mm. You're going to cut straight down and around here. You're going to cut this down here, and this area here, this part here, one there, and that one there, and that one there, everything in line with this will be cut down about 15mm. You can go a little bit more if you want, no problems. Now, this part here, this one, in this part here, all the way through to here, you need to go further. And you can see there's probably about maybe 8mm from the shell. And the reason why you're going to cut that is so that the pusher has somewhere to go against. And you can see I've cut a little bit more than necessary. Maybe you don't have to go that far, but it doesn't matter too much. Similar story, this one here, I haven't cut, it's worked so far, but I think it will hang up on this, so it would probably just shave a little bit of this down too. When you do that, take your choice of solenoid. Whoops, your uncle. You'll see that this portion right here, this piece of webbing, will interface in through this gap right there. This one sits in here, and when you close the lid, it clamps down on here on quite strong. You've got the screws in here, so it's holding from these locations down. And this back piece here, it's not holding up and down this way, but it is holding this way. So when you've got all this sort of movement going along here, this is actually taking the brunt of that, along with this here. This one's not actually taking that. So it's fairly straightforward. One of the things that you will notice is that, if I just pop this bad boy out, is that the cages are a little bit different. It's mostly due to the characteristics of the individual solenoids. So this one here is a bit taller to support this being 2mm taller, that particular solenoid. As I said, it's a little bit taller. Screw holes are in a different place. You've got the label there to say it's an FTW or a 35mm solenoid, no problems. The bottom component is a little bit different here. This is an old version, but I'll show you this here. The bottom component is a bit different, and that's for a couple of reasons. So first is this area here will foul with the shell, so I've had to cut that away in either case. But then with the 35mm solenoid, what they do is they just fold that piece of steel around, and you end up with a bit of a lump here. So in order to get this in just the perfect position, I've cut cut the model away at these points here, so that you can sit the solenoid lower in the frame and just get that perfect position without having to worry about the individual characteristics of each solenoid, because each of these are a little bit different. Some of them are nice and flat, some of them they got quite a big bulge there, and so on and so forth, right? There is just a little bit of room in here in case you've got something that's got wires in the way or whatnot, but generally speaking it's not a problem. And you would screw in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's the same on both. The actual nub, you print this out, you just thread it down. This has got the requisite, I think it's an M4 thread in it, so you just sort of thread it in, no problems. With the 35mm solenoid, you actually have to take the sort of two nuts that are on this off before you can do anything, so you need to use some vise or something like that to get them off. It's no big problem, but they are sort of thread locked on, so you need to crack it off, clean the threads out, no problems. Keep this here, that's quite good. Change the spring while you're at it, because the stock spring in there is a shit house. That's a 0.8mm wire, 45mm long, 14mm that way, and that will get you 13, 14, oh, I think I got 16 darts a second in a dominator, and that was pushing it really hard. It really depends on the battery voltage and all that sort of stuff, right? You've got to get it just right to get that high level of performance out of it. Not quite such a big deal, because what they cut the frame and bend the frame a little bit differently, so you don't end up with that sort of piece of nub out there. But you will need to take the nylock nut off it, and then thread on the requisite sort of push a bit. What we do here is we feed the wires in through this way here, because each of these is different in that, you know, it can be a little bit fatter down there, and we just slide it in place. Screw it in, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, no problems. Bob's your uncle. You'll find these on my Thingiverse page, they'll be linked. Enjoy making a build with them. Do you need to use this? No. You can certainly attempt to attach the solenoid into the right position, but what you'll find is that this will line up the solenoid just perfectly, so that you have a reliable pusher, as opposed to one that is offset in a weird location, or one that is glued in place and will come unglued after a couple of hundred shots, or one that's bolted through the side of the shell and looks a bit ghetto. But you know, it's up to you. When you do print these things, what is very important is to make sure that the undersides here are nice and flat, so use the requisite amount of support. And unfortunately you've got that big ass piece hanging out here. I print these solid. I don't think you save a lot of plastic if you print them with infill, because they're only quite thin anyway. But you know, the solid certainly sort of holds it quite well. So as always, if you have any issues, just sort of write a comment or something like that, and we can sort of work our way through it. But yeah, enjoy.